miners' tracks separated right back yonder. It's my guess that they're going to prospect off from separate directions and then meet someplace later on.
Lieutenant, we'll take Sergeant Mason and four men, follow the left-hand fork of this trail to the next ridgeline. Then cut across and meet us on the other side. If you see any hostile Indians, take no offensive action. Clear?
Yes, sir. Sergeant?
Sir?
Close ranks.
Strange the things that some men will go through for a little poke full of gold.
Lieutenant Rutter's in a fight.
At a gallop, ho!
He had been the youngest general in the Civil War. Within 5 years, he had been reduced in rank and sent west to be forgotten. But he was not the kind of man to let the world forget. His name, George Armstrong Custer.
Dead as I'll ever be.
Report, Lieutenant.
We spotted them down there in the valley. Yellow Bellies tried to make a run for it. That's as far as they got.
A Sioux hunting party.
Indian's an Indian to me. We just might have saved those miners' lives.
Before we heard your firing, Lieutenant, we found those miners, all four of them. Dead.
That makes it plain enough, doesn't it? We just evened up the score.
Did we, Lieutenant? You just slaughtered a Sioux hunting party.
And what difference does that make? We're at war with the Sioux.
Not officially, Lieutenant. Our orders are to control and contain the Sioux. With less than 1,000 troops to patrol 500,000 square miles of frontier, we can't afford to provoke any more trouble than we already have.
I think you're forgetting 4 dead miners.
The braves who killed those miners were Cheyenne.
One plains tribe is just as guilty as another. As soon as we wipe them all out, the better.
This is not a war of extermination, Lieutenant.
It's not a war at all the way you fight it. You won't tame them by running from them.
That's enough, Lieutenant. I'm placing you on report unless you wish to retract what you've said.
Cavalry officer, but I'd say we're on a dang fool's errand.
We'll talk about it later.
Dang fool's errand is right. That could be the seventh's middle name. About all anybody ever thinks we're good for.
Lieutenant Rutford. You've only been with us a few months. Stay around a while. You'll find out that you joined up with the best.
I'm not staying any longer than I have to. Custer in bad graces with the powers that be. Third-rate details, that's all we'll ever see. I had a belly full of the seventh.
Lieutenant Redford.
Yes, sir?
In this outfit, we take care of our horses before we take care of ourselves. I suggest you get to it.
Yes, sir.
Colonel?
Yes.
It's my Lieutenant Rutford. You know how he feels about you.
I'm not concerned about his feelings, Sergeant. I'm short of officers as it is. I need him.
Knowing he hates you?
Runs in his family. All the way from praise to hate. Lieutenant Rutford's gone the full circle. 15 hours a day in the saddle can develop blisters of disillusion. What do you think, Joe?
Your old Galala's, I'd say. That blasted young lieutenant went and killed some of Crazy Horse's people. You know, General, our luck's are running all to the bad.
Colonel Custer, can I speak to you for a minute?
Alone?
Sure, Mason.
Lieutenant Rutford didn't mention it, but I figure it's my duty to say something.
What is it?
These Indians we were fighting. There were 5 of them. Now, we wounded the last one, but he got away from us.
Colonel Custer! Up there!
Let's ride! Sergeant Mason and your detachment and head south by Thunder Ridge. I'll try to draw the main body of them north through the canyon. We'll rendezvous at Broken Pine Summit in 3 hours.
sir. Sergeant?
Lieutenant, this time do as you're told. The greatest weapon is speed. Use it. Under no circumstances attempt to fight. Move out.
Sir.
Drop guidons. Everyone quiet. Now's a chance to even up the odds. Form a line facing the bend. No one fire till I give the order.
Surprise party we give them, I'll bet them Indians are still off down in that canyon, a sneaking a slow peek around every bend.
Well, we lost them for now, anyway. I don't see any sign of Lieutenant Rudford and his detachment.
They had the shortest ride. They should have been here before us. It's way past their rendezvous time, too.
They must have run into some trouble.
We have to circle back to the ridge and take a look for them.
Give the lieutenant strict orders to follow the ridge to a broken pine summit. He ain't gonna be off down yonder.
He didn't follow Thunder Ridge as I ordered him to.
Buster sure ain't one to follow orders. He took that South Valley not 5 miles from where we left him.
Mount up! Couldn't have been that bunch of bucks that were following us that got him. There must be something that we don't know about.
Crazy Horse is no ordinary chief. He knows the strategy of separating forces.
Go fight him or run him a horse race.
Move out!
Watch out!
Custer's patrol?
Aye, sir. The colonel sent a trooper on ahead.
Trouble?
Bad trouble, sir.
Any casualties?
I'd not be knowing the details yet, but some of Colonel Custer's men have been killed.
I was afraid of that. Any expedition into the Black Hills is like a slap in the face to the Sioux. After Custer sees to his men, will you have a report to me here?
Aye.
And, Captain Keogh, you will not mention our visitor to him.
I wasn't planning to, sir.
Very good. And Captain, will you see to it that our visitor has the proper accommodations? He is a personal friend of the President of the United States.
The President? Aye, sir.
Politicians. If only they'd leave the army blasted well alone. That's all, Captain Keogh. Did you recognize any of them?
Teton Sioux, sir. Crazy Horse's tribe.
Crazy Horse? You were lucky to get out of there at all.
General, I only spotted four bodies of Lieutenant Rudford's command. Well, it's not likely there were any survivors. I'd like to make sure.
What did you have in mind?
I request permission to take a patrol back there tonight.
Isn't that just what Crazy Horse would be expecting you to do? He's probably up there waiting for you.
A calculated risk, sir. But if there are possibly two men up there alive...
Colonel, the men in Lieutenant Rudford's command must be counted as dead. And the affair entered into the record as ended. Colonel Custer, you have a genius for making powerful enemies. Like General Sherman. And now, for some reason or other, one of the most influential publishers in America. Here, take a look at these. Vain. Glory-seeking. Unfit to command. With these newspaper articles, Lieutenant Rudford's father is making you famous. Or, should I say, infamous.
I've read most of them, sir.
Why is John Rudford out to nail your hide to the barn door? Well, whatever it is, he's got all the more reason to hate you now. I guess I'd better go tell him about his son.
He's here?
Arrived this morning from Washington with orders releasing his son for military service.
I'd prefer to meet Mr. Rudford myself, sir. I think I should be the one to tell him.
All right. I'll have the sentry bring him here.
See me?
Mr. Rudford, I'm sorry to have to tell you, but your son is missing in action against the Sioux. Must be presumed dead.
Presumed dead? How? How did it happen?
On patrol, sir.
Under your command?
Yes, sir. I gave him an order and...
Weren't you satisfied with killing one member of my family? Did you have to murder my son, too, with your inept orders?
I didn't kill your son.
I don't want to hear any more about it.
But you will listen just the same, Mr. Rudford. If your son had obeyed my orders...
I would expect you to pass the blame to a man who cannot defend himself.
You have no reason to doubt Colonel Custer.
I have every reason. There are many forms of murder, General. Such as the way your Colonel Custer murdered my younger brother during the Civil War.
That's strong language, Mr. Rudford. I realize that you're overwrought, but...
I mean every word I say. My brother rode with Custer in the Michigan Brigade and was killed in a senseless, glory-seeking charge against Jeb Stuart's Virginia cavalry.
And I rode 100 yards in front of his unit during that charge.
That's easy to say.
And easy to prove.
With your insane, self-seeking instincts, I'm sure you're right.
May I be excused, sir?
You won't get away with it this time, Custer. Your craze for glory killed my son, and I won't rest until I prove it.
There are only four dead soldiers. You let two of them get away. Now we will find those two.
One of them is an officer.
Colonel
know you pretty well, Colonel. Every time you act that soldierly around me, you want something.
I respectfully request the General's permission to take three or four of my men to return to the Black Hills tonight.
Custer, I told you...
If for no other reason, sir, and to bury the troopers there.
At ease, Colonel. Custer, I know how you feel. Every time a man in the 7th is killed, you blame yourself for it. That's part of the price every leader has to pay for his right to command. But you carry it too far. Learn to control it, or it's going to tear your guts out, Custer. Your request is denied. You return to garrison and foraging duties in the morning with the 7th. Dismissed.
Returning tonight to the Black Hills. Check on Lieutenant Rutledge's detachment. I saw only four bodies. It's quite possible there are two men up there we can save. More likely, they're all dead, and this will only be a burial detail. It's also quite likely all of us who go won't be coming back. I want four volunteers.
Count on me, sir.
Thank you, Rio. And the rest of you, too. Sergeant, pick your men. Iron rations for 3 days. We'll be traveling fast and light.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and Sergeant, don't make any unnecessary noise. We wouldn't want to disturb General Terry's sleep.
Come in.
Colonel.
Mr. Redford.
I'd like a word with you, Colonel.
All right, Mr. Rutledge.
I've been talking to some of the men. It seems you saw only four bodies out of that six-man patrol.
That's correct.
And you didn't even go down to investigate?
Did you also hear that we were attacked by Indians when we spotted those bodies?
I don't care if you were attacked by the whole Sioux Nation. You had no right to leave without finding out if those other two men were alive.
Don't concern yourself with my rights, Mr. Rutledge. I'm heading out now with a detail to find out if those men are alive.
I'm going with you.
No, you're not.
Let me remind you, Custer, I'm a civilian. You cannot order me around.
That's precisely the reason you're not going.
You're dealing with a little more than you can handle, Colonel.
I don't like that man. I wouldn't trust him as far as I could throw him.
Careful, Sergeant. You're liable to get your name in the papers.
Seen tonight. They're all spread out like a fishnet.
Yeah, we're the fish. We don't stand a chance on foot, but if we could get to their horses.
Lieutenant, I hope you're not planning on trying to sneak up on a Sioux.
Not in his own mountains.
I didn't ask for your opinion, Sergeant.
I'd like the lieutenant's permission to speak, if I may.
I don't need advice.
Lieutenant, I've been out here on this frontier a long time.
Surprise is the important element. You take them from the other side, I'll get them from here.
Now, you've got 2 minutes to get into position, Sergeant. Move out.
Lieutenant, it just won't work. Now, we've got to keep hidden. Try to sneak our way.
I gave you an order, Sergeant. Move out.
Have it your way, Lieutenant.
I intend to, Sergeant. Don't you forget it.
Lieutenant, those horses are going to give us away. That's for sure. Let me take a look at it.
Come on.
Lieutenant.
Yeah.
Just try to put your weight on me. That's it. That way.
If you'll pardon me for saying so, Lieutenant, you've given about enough orders.
Shape to go with us, California?
Well, I ain't well enough to stay here. Especially after General Terry finds out that you disobeyed his orders about going back.
It'll be a hard ride.
I never knew you to pick an easy one.
It's not much further, Lieutenant.
Where are we going?
Remember, some caves on the side of this hill.
Night all by your lonesome can be mighty dangerous. You just about got a knife in your gizzard.
Where's Custer?
He ain't gonna have the welcome mat out for you, but I'll take you to him.
Come on, let's go.
Him a
follower. Well, a man accustomed to giving orders, you're not very good at taking them, are you, Mr. Redford?
I don't take orders from you, Custer.
I'm here because my son is out there somewhere, and I intend to find him.
I told you I wouldn't take you along with us.
You don't have much choice in the matter.
You're wrong, Mr. Redford. Sergeant, we're returning to Fort Hays immediately.
No, wait. Listen to me. Please, don't let our personal differences make you do something you'll regret later. Those two men may still be alive, but certainly they can't be for much longer. Custer, it's my son out there.
All right, Mr. Redford. You go with us.
Ooh.
Lieutenant. Here. With that fever of yours, you've got to have something. Even if it's only water. Easy.
Where are we?
We're hidden pretty good in some rocks. Only trouble is, it's right in the middle of the whole Sioux Nation. Now, you just lie back. You lost a lot of blood. When I went to get this water, I was afraid it might be a waste of time.
Everything's so vague, I can't get it clear in my mind yet.
You countermanded Colonel Custer's orders. He ordered your men down off the ridge into the valley to attack them Indians.
There was only three of them.
Yes, sir. They led you right into a trap of more than 50.
It's easy to see I'm not one of your favorite officers.
Lieutenant, I despise every square inch of you.
That's a bit hypocritical, isn't it? Staying behind and take care of me?
I'm a soldier. I wouldn't run off and leave one of my own men.
Even when you despise him? You're a fool, Sergeant. A man's first thought is self-survival. Why? Why'd you do it? No, I wouldn't have.
The way I see it, this uniform of mine is not just a piece of cloth. It makes me a part of my country. If you understand that, it seems to make a better man out of you. Make me the right kind of soldier, too. Something. It's more than likely us.
We gotta get out of here.
No, we'll stand a better chance tonight, Lieutenant. Just lie back and get your strength. Oh. You're gonna need it.
Colonel Custer.
Mr. Redford. This is the fifth time in the last 2 hours you've rode up here to tell me how to conduct this mission. Now, unless you have something important to say...
I overheard two of the men talking. They say you're taking the long way to where you saw my son's detachment.
That is correct.
Is that an example of the famous Custer Dash, taking the long way and walking your horses while you're doing it?
The Sioux undoubtedly know we're here somewhere, Mr. Redford. We didn't take the short way into the valley because that's the way they'd be expecting us to come. And we're walking our horses, so when we do come into action, they'll have the strength to carry some of us out of here alive. Now go back to your place in the column. Took
a pretty good look around before I come down here. The four of them's all I found. Sergeant and
Lieutenant Redford's missing. If I know anything about Crazy Horse, we never rode this far back into the Black Hills without him knowing about it. And it just ain't like him to leave us alone.
But it is like Crazy Horse to pick his time and his place for an attack. Sergeant?
It'll be dark soon. After you bury the men, we'll make cold camp here tonight.
Camp? You mean you're just going to sleep this night away when there are two men out there who need us?
Give your orders, Sergeant.
We'll make camp here tonight. Break out the shovels.
Listen. Listen to me. I'll give $1,000 for every man who'll go up into those hills tonight to look for my son. $1,000.
You know, Mr. Redford, these Black Hills get a whole lot blacker after dark. Only thing we'd find up yonder would be some graves for ourselves.
Sleep. I was thinking.
We got no time to talk now, Lieutenant. We got to get ourselves out of here.
Come on, Lieutenant. We got to keep moving.
Crazy Horse is keeping himself. Him and none of his braves are back yonder in the gorge no place.
Sergeant Bustard, hand me that dynamite. Men can hold off a dozen from here. This looks like as good a place as any. Take the men on through, I'll finish up.
Yes, sir.
What is Custer doing?
I found out the general will tell you if he wants you to know what's on his mind.
That may apply to this so-called military detachment, but I'm here looking for my son. I'm under no authority of the army.
Let me give you a good piece of advice, Mr. Rudford. Don't go a-testing that out on the general.
You know, Custer, every needless delay jeopardizes the lives of those two men.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Redford. Just as I'm aware of the jeopardy the rest of us are in. How badly we may need a chance to get out of here alive.
Okay, mount him up. Mount him up.
General, maybe we should have rode down to the other end of the valley.
Well, if Mason and Redford had escaped, they would have headed for the protection of the rocks, not the open area.
You know, I used to trap with a little boy that had a pretty good rule on how to stay alive when faced with going into hostile territory.
What was that?
Don't go in. I'm beginning to see his point.
Sure hit the nail on the head, General. Crazy horse picked his time and his place.
Jim! Redford, come back! It's a trap!
Men, let's go home.
Yes, in a military sense, your mission can be called a success. But also in a military sense, you willfully disobeyed orders. And I intend to see to it...
Sir, you can see Lieutenant Redford now, sir.
You and I'll settle this later. Right now, we've got to see the boy.
If you don't mind, sir, I'd like to check on my men first.
Lieutenant Redford is one of your men, Colonel, whether you like it or not. And frankly, I don't think you are going to like it.
A couple of days in bed, you'll be ready for anything. I've got some plans for you.
Ah, General. Redford, I want to tell you how happy I am that your son is safe.
Thank you, General. But the point is, I don't think there was any reason for his being in danger at all. And I'm going to see it doesn't happen again.
Tim, I have a release from the military service for you, signed by the Secretary of War.
So you no longer have anything to fear from this man. Tell me, son, isn't it true that Colonel Custer did, in fact, send you into the hands of hostiles, then abandon you? Tim, I asked you a question. Is it not true that Colonel Custer abandoned you and your men?
few days ago, I would have said yes. That would be a lie. Dad, do you know what happened out there? A man died for me. A man that hated me and everything I believe in. He said he wasn't just wearing a uniform. He was wearing a piece of his country. He said if you believed in that, you were a better man.
All right, son. I'm also very grateful to Sergeant Mason, but...
Let me finish, Dad. He taught me what being a soldier means. Sharing peril with other men. Understanding that your life depends on their judgment and loyalty. Just as theirs upon yours.
Tim, don't you know why I'm here? Why I got your release from the military? I want you to come back and help me run the paper.
I'm going to stay here, Dad. If they'll have me.
What do you mean, if they'll have you?
I'm going to tell you something Colonel Custer already knows. What happened out there was my fault, because I disobeyed his orders. 4 men died because of my fool mistake. And even knowing I wasn't worth it, a 5th died trying to save me.
They can't prove that. What's more, you're no longer under their jurisdiction. Once you sign this paper, you're out of the Army for good.
I'm going to stay in the 7th Cavalry, Dad. I want to stay. And take my medicine.
Welcome to the regiment, Lieutenant.
See me, sir?
Custer, I want you to dictate a full report on your mission into the Black Hills to rescue Lieutenant Rutford. And I expect an explanation as to why you disobeyed my direct order. Just the facts as they occurred. The bare facts. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
I want to see it the minute it's finished, Corporal. Custer, you've done a good job. Corporal, as soon as Colonel Custer's finished, record the fact that the mission was undertaken at my order.